Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to St. Thomas Fifth Avenue for this slightly delayed 5:15 recital. Apologies for evensong running a little long. Very pleased to present the first of two organ recitals, in fact, this week. Please do consider coming back next Saturday if you're in the vicinity. A keyboard extravaganza at 3 o'clock next Saturday afternoon, which will feature yours truly, along with my wonderful, illustrious, and greatly revered colleagues, Wayne Marshall and David Briggs. And we're going to put all the instruments of the church through their paces, which includes this wonderful Steinway D piano we have over here. It's really the concert to mark the addition of our wonderful nave console here, which has been so generously donated by Barbara and Carl Saunders. So it's really to mark that, but it's going to be an extravaganza, and we've commissioned a new piece from David Briggs for all three instruments, for the Dobson organ, for the Taylor and Booty at the back, and for the Steinway D, and they will be played simultaneously. That's 3 o'clock next Saturday afternoon. Please come along if you're in town. This evening, I'm very pleased to present some music by Calvin Hampton, very much a New York composer, who of course died prematurely, an early casualty of the AIDS epidemic in 1984, sadly, just as his creative voice was really seemed to be burgeoning, did something extraordinarily special. The choir is going to record an album of Calvin Hampton's choral music just in 2 or 3 weeks' time, and we're going to include some of the organ music that you will hear tonight, notably the Concerto for Solo Organ, which rarely gets an outing these days. It's a fantastic piece, I think, virtuoso piece, and by Calvin Hampton's own admission, rather mirrors the techniques and the ideas of Béla Bartók's Concerto for Orchestra, well-known orchestral work that is equally fabulous in the way that material is presented in block-like structures. It doesn't sort of develop as such, but everything's juxtaposed next to each other, and the stark contrast between the ideas and the colors, I hope, are very clear to be heard, as they are indeed in Bartók's original model. Calvin Hampton was born in Pennsylvania, but he spent most of his career here in New York. He studied with Fenner Douglas at Oberlin and with Arthur Poister at Syracuse, two very illustrious names in educational parlance in the organ world. But in 1963, he became director of music just downtown in Gramercy Park at the parish of Calvary. And from 1972 until 82, for 10 years, he performed free midnight organ recitals every Friday at Calvary. Rather similar to the great Compline tradition in Seattle's St. Mark's Cathedral, people came after partying or eating or drinking on a Friday night, and they would lie on the floor in Calvary Church and just absorb some of the great organ works at midnight. Must have been an extraordinary experience, I can imagine, but it was often packed, and people speak of these recitals in hallowed ways these days. But it is that in New York for which he's primarily famous. But he gave organ recitals across the US and also in Europe. He was very interested in organ design. And over his time at Calvary, he tinkered and tweaked the organ down there, which was originally a 1930s Aeolian Skinner. But he bought pipework and then constructed Winchests and added and subtracted bits and pieces of the organ. He even acquired, apparently, a stop that was built by Aristide Cavaillé-Coll, the great French organ builder of the 19th century, which apparently still resides in the organ, although the organ itself down at Calvary is non-functional today, sadly. But he was very much known for his ideas on organ design and collaborated with Fisk, the organ builder Fisk, who put in a magnificent organ in Meyerson Symphony Center in Dallas. He's primarily known now for his church and organ compositions, but he did write 4 concertos. He also wrote a number of hymns, some of which made their way into the Episcopal 1982 hymnal, some very lovely tunes, very much perhaps of their time, but don't see the light of day, sadly, very much nowadays. But they're very beautifully crafted, very elegant hymn tunes. much of his organ music, there are 11 substantial works. Much of that organ music is published by Wayne Leupold these days. And you're going to hear a smattering tonight of those works. The two middle pieces, Pageant and Imperialism, come from a set of three pieces where he deliberately took models of French composers. In Paradisum is supposed to recreate the static mysticism, if you will, and colours of some of Olivier Messiaen's music. And Pageant, which you'll hear just before it, looks to some of Jean Alain's interesting experiments in juxtapositions of organ colour and ideas, again, in sort of stark contrast, jutted up against each other. So Alain and Messiaen are very much the models for those two pieces. I told you about the concerto. I hope you enjoy that. Materna for musical organ, I've included, it's a little chorale prelude based on America the Beautiful, because it is America the Beautiful. It's very charming and seductive, I think. Then I'm going to start with ceremonial music. He wrote two pieces called Ceremonial Music, and this one's called Trumpets from 1975. I hope you enjoy this little foray into Calvin Hampton's New York music. Thank you.